The hadith of Sahih Bukhari, volume number one. It's mentioned that Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, Hazrat Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, she narrates that I was between Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Qibla when the Prophet was praying, and before he did the sujood, he pushed my leg and I moved my leg aside, indicating that in the salah, the Prophet touched the leg of Hazrat Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, and yet continued his salah, indicating that physical touch does not break the wudu. And there are several Sahih hadith, other hadith, which prove to us that physical touch does not break the wudu. This hadith is of Sahih Bukhari, volume number 1, hadith number 519. Now I'm asking the question, who is right? The opinion of Imam Abu Hanifa or the opinion of Imam Shafi? Imam Abu Hanifa. Because his opinion is matching with the Quran as well as the authentic hadith. So somebody will ask me, do you mean to say that Imam Shafi was wrong? Let's see, we respect Imam Shafi. May Allah's mercy be on him, Rahimahullah. We respect him, we revere him, and we love him. And the Prophet said that anyone who gives opinion after doing research, any scholar gives the opinion, if the opinion is correct, he gets one reward. Sorry, if the opinion is correct, he gets two rewards. If the opinion is wrong, he gets one reward. Any scholar gives a fatwa, gives the opinion. If it is correct, he gets two rewards. But even if it is wrong, he gets one reward. I'm not saying that Imam Shafi, may Allah's mercy be on him, that he was not intelligent. He was very intelligent. He was very knowledgeable. But we have to realize that during the time of Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Shafi, may Allah's mercy be on them all the hadiths weren't compiled. The compilation of the hadith started before but completed later on. So maybe this hadith of Abu Dawud, volume number 1, chapter number 70, hadith number 179, as well as hadith of Sahih Bukhari, volume number 1, hadith number 519, it did not reach Imam Shafi. So because it did not reach him, he took one of the two options, physical touch or sexual touch. He took it as physical touch. Not that he was not intelligent, maybe this hadith didn't reach him. So based on his knowledge of the Quran, which can have one of the two meanings, he took one meaning. Not that he made a mistake purposefully. What we say, maybe this hadith didn't reach him. Let me give you another example. I asked the question that in the salah, in the loud salah, the salah of Fajr, of Maghrib and Isha, after the Imam completes Surah Fatiha, according to the Hanafi Maslak, should the people in the congregation, should they say Salah, should they say Ameen loudly or no? According to Abu Hanifa, according to the Hanafi Maslak, you should not say Ameen loudly after the Imam completes his Surah Fatiha in the loud Salah. But according to Imam Shafi, may Allah's mercy be on him, should the people, the Muttadi, the congregation, should they say Ameen loudly or no? The answer is yes. Simple. Everyone knows about it. Everyone knows about it. In the Hanafi Madhab, you don't have to say Ameen loudly. In the Shafi Madhab, you have to say loudly. In the Fajr, Maghrib and the Isha Salah. Who is right? If you don't know, you have to go to Quran and the Hadith. We don't find any verse in the Quran which says that should we say Ameen loudly or not. So we get to the next source. We go to the next source, that is the Sahih Hadith. Now when we read the Sahih Hadith, it's mentioned in Sahih Bukhari, volume number 1, In the book of Adhan, chapter number 111, hadith number 780, Prophet peace be upon him, he said that, say Ameen loudly after Surah Fatiha finish. Say Ameen loudly, and if your Ameen coincides with the Ameen of the angels, then all your past sins will be forgiven. The next hadith, Sahih Bukhari, volume number 1, in the book of Adhan, chapter number 112, hadith number 781, the Prophet said, if the Ameen of any one of you coincides with the Ameen of any one of the angels, then all your past sins will be forgiven. Sahih Bukhari, volume number 1, book of Adhan, chapter number 113, hadith number 782, the Prophet said that after the Imam says, Ghairil Maghdubi Alayhim Waladdallin, say Ameen loudly. And if your Ameen coincides with the Ameen of the angels, all your past sins will be forgiven. I have quoted no less than 3 hadith from Sahih Bukhari that you should say Ameen loudly after Surah Fatiha. Similarly, there are no less than 6 hadith in Sahih Muslim. If you read Sahih Muslim, volume number 1, in the book of Salah, chapter number 116, hadith number 811 to 816, there are no less than 6 hadith in Sahih Muslim which says you should say Ameen loudly. So I have given you references of at least 9 Sahih hadith which says that you should say Ameen loudly. Now I ask you the question, who is correct, the Hanafi Maslak or the Shafi Maslak? The Shafi Maslak. Simple. What matches with the Quran and Sahih Hadith, you follow that. Simple. Now, coming to the question. The first question, that does the wudu break or not when a person accidentally, if a man accidentally touches a woman or a woman touches a man? Imagine if a non-Muslim who accepts Islam and he asked me, Brother Zakir, if a woman touches me accidentally, or if I touch a woman accidentally when I'm in wudu, am I yet in the state of wudu or not? Does my wudu break or not? So will I ask him, that is your father Hanafi or a Shafi? See, his father was a non-Muslim. So my answer should be based on Quran and Sahih Hadith. And when we analyze the Quran and Sahih Hadith, we come to know that the wudu does not break. So irrespective whether you come from any background, unless someone comes and tells me, see Brother Zakir, you know that the Hanafis have got some oil in their skin and the Shafi don't have oil, therefore the Hanafi, the wudu doesn't break and the Shafi breaks. If someone gives me some scientific reason, then maybe I'll have to think over it. But there's no such thing that the skin of the Hanafi is different and the skin of the Shafi is different. You have to go back to Allah and His Rasul. And when we do research in the Quran and Sahih Hadith, we get the answer. Again, somebody may ask me in the second question that saying Ameen loudly, Imam Shafi is correct, and Hanafi Maslak not to say Ameen loudly. Do you mean to say Abu Hanifa was wrong? Didn't he have knowledge? No, spiller. Imam Abu Hanifa, may Allah's mercy be on him, Rahimahullah. He was a great scholar. We love him, we respect him. But not that he made a mistake purposefully. Maybe these hadith which I quoted of Sahih Bukhari, volume number 1, hadith number 781 to 782, and the hadith of Sahih Muslim, volume number 1, hadith number 811 to 816, this may not have reached him. As I told you earlier, that when the Prophet was alive,